So last week I asked you what kind of impact do you want to have in your career, in your relationships, in your life. This week, let's attach your goals to that impact. But before we do, little Joe has some big data.
Thanks, Big Joe. A Harvard study suggests that 83% of the U.S. population do not have goals. Only 3 out of every 100 adults write their goals down on paper. You gotta be kidding me. Yet people with written goals are 50% more likely to achieve them than those without goals.
So what does that mean, little Joe?
That people should set goals and write them down?
Yes, and today I'm gonna share a simple, realistic plan that works. And more importantly, I'm going to talk about the linchpin that determines why many people fail at reaching their goals while others persevere, increasing their motivation, self-confidence, and success.
I love it.
Ah, thanks, little Joe. This is your morning boost. Let's go. Before we get started, I want to thank our sponsor, Victory Consulting, which is a learning and development firm, where for over 20 years, they have been building high-performing teams, leaders, presenters, and salespeople. By the way, that was an egregious self-plug because I am the founder of Victory Consulting, but I'm also the sponsor and paying for this. So again, victoryconsulting.com. Let's move on. Having been in the motivational business for a long time, over the years I've heard people talk about setting short-term goals, setting long-term goals, creating a storyboard with specific descriptions, detailing a plan for each and every goal, writing letters to yourself about how you're going to feel when you accomplish that goal, visualizing achieving your goal in a meditative zen-like state. And then?
Yo, Joey, you gotta be kidding me. By the time I did all that, I'd fall asleep in my pasta fazool.
Exactly, Uncle Polly. For some people, that's a good plan. But for most people I know, we must...
Simplify!
And here's how. You make two types of lists. First, you create a make it happen list. This list focuses on things you're accomplishing today or within a week. An example of things that might fall under the make it happen list include getting a good workout in, an important meeting with a prospective client, completing your expense report, taking a walk with your significant other, getting your oil changed. Now, the make it happen list may not seem significant with regard to motivation, but it is, and here's why. With each goal you complete, you check it off. You've completed it, you feel more productive. And when you feel more productive, you create little wins that establish big momentum. And this leads to your big goals list. These are the goals you believe will fulfill your ambition and your passion. Again, the key here is, Uncle Polly,
simplify.
Think about 2 to 4 goals you'd like to accomplish in about a 3 to 12 month time frame. Sometimes shorter, sometimes longer, but that's a reasonable range for bigger goals. Now, I know we've stressed the importance of simplicity, but big goals require a big commitment. So when you set those, make sure you ask yourself these questions. Why is this a goal I want to accomplish? What actions are required to get this done? What resources do I need to execute them? When is my realistic ideal deadline? And most importantly, which is vital for discipline, am I willing to work through the tough times to complete them? At the beginning, I talked about the linchpin that separates why people fail and other people succeed when it comes to goals. That linchpin is having people to talk to. Having conversations with people, again, who will be honest with you is critical for staying positive, staying committed, and staying disciplined in your pursuit of your big goals list. Our old friend and famous motivator, Earl Nightingale, said, "Success is the progressive realization of a worthy goal." But if you don't have specific goals set, then what's going to make you purposeful? Or if you do have goals, but you don't write them down, then what is your GPS to reach that destination? Whether it's your make it happen list, more short term, your big goals list, more long term, the key is write your goals down. This is instrumental for feeling inspired to live your life with more enthusiasm, more confidence, and more joy. Little Joe?
Thanks, Big Joe. 3 final questions, folks. Number 1, what goals have you set for your business and your personal growth and passions? Number 2, can you quickly articulate them? And number 3, Do you write them down and look at them every day so you are on track to accomplish them? What the heck, guys? Why are you blocking me out? That is way uncool.
That's probably because you're Little Joe.
Yeah, not funny, Big Joe.
Seriously, please do answer Little Joe's questions below. And also, don't forget to subscribe, share with others, and smash that like button.